As we think about the staff we honor tonight throughout our system, we do so in an era of great organizational and industrial change. And to some degree, you're honoring people for being who they are and the values that they bring and the consistency that they bring to the job every day. Trish Traynor was the first person I hired here at Adapt Community Network 28 years ago. She's done everything we asked her to do and done so with humor, with value, and a great sense of purpose for every person that we provide supports to.
It's been a wonderful 27 years here at Adapt Community Network, and I'm fortunate to work with so many wonderful people that really share a common goal and really want the individuals to have experiences that otherwise they may not have had. Change is important because everything changes, and if you're going to survive, you have to adapt. I think we're in the right direction with the change of our name to Adapt Community Network. I think we are letting families know and letting other agencies know and letting anybody who is ready to listen that we're willing to change with what's going on with government, what's going on in the communities, and how to keep families safe and still be able to receive services.
Helen Zhang is someone who becomes a key staff person. She's our programmer. Without Helen, we couldn't move into this century with the information technology that we all have to have in order to do the business that we do and to provide the supports that we do.
Adapted me. My career started in here at Adapt. I just got my master's degree and I tried to find a job just like anyone find a job. So I was a very, very junior person. And Adapt trusted me to give me the opportunity to let me grow up, become a truly IT professional.
George Schiller's been here as long as I have. He's been a messenger. He's worked at administrative support. And the best thing about George is that whether you're having a great day, a poor day, whether it's raining, sun is shining, snowing, George always has a hello and asks you how you're doing. And frankly, it doesn't get any better than that.
I really love doing my job. And that's something that I do not take for granted. A lot of people can't say that they've worked for 30 years anywhere. And I'm truly blessed. It's important in life for people to be happy and enjoy what it is that they're doing. If I can make a person smile, then I've done something wonderful, not just for myself, but for someone else.
Beverly Ellman has been with us for 40 years. We've offered her promotional opportunities, but all she wants to do is to work with the children in the Bronx and to be that person that's there for them every day.
When I first started as a teenager volunteer, someone said to me, "Oh, you're not crying?" And I said, should I? And they said, "Well," and I said, "but they're kids." I'd always wanted to be a teacher, but at this point I wanted to be a special ed teacher, learn more about it, and then hope that I could develop skills that would make a difference in helping the child reach their maximum. That has been what's my driving force, and that's been my love and my passion. And I think having Adapt as a larger family now, we're able to pull some resources that may not have been there before because we're ever expanding. Over the years, you don't realize how many lives you've touched. Somebody once said to me, "You know, you've touched probably over 1,000. I said, "No, it's not, it's impossible." But then when you add up how many years and how many children go through here every year, it's in the thousands. And some I still remember by name, the names slip me now, but the faces are there, and they're still part of us.
So for all of these people, we at Adapt Community Network are proud to have them and are very glad we're able to honor them tonight.